So we start from the outside. So basically, the school I'm attending, it's located near the city. So, and as you can see here, we have a parking lot which the students can park. So basically, most of the students is not from the city. They live quite far away. They often drive their car to here. Like one person I know, he drives to school around 30 minutes. And then other students drive here around 1 or 2 hours. And they do it every time they have the courses. And it's quite far for them. And me, I live close by, so I come here by the bus. So the course starts at 9 o'clock. As you can see now, it's around 8:52 and not many people show up. It's a normal thing. And the normal stuff we have is to test ourselves. So because it's a very, very hands-on learning, so you have to test a lot. And as for the courses, I can explain to you. So it has 2 years. The first year, we have a lot of electrical construction, mechanics, steering system, and machine safety and other stuff. And as for second year, we have 2 internships and mathematics and learning work industry ET and the project works. As for the course length, as you can see here, each course is around 5 weeks, and you have 3 days to go to school, 2 days you study yourself. For mechatronics course, it's a course that you can work with different pneumatics, and it's mainly on the computer simulation. So personally, I don't like the course, but you have to take it anyways. And the teacher also does a lecture sometimes. I personally don't like it because he's not very structured. However, if you have any questions, you have to ask him in person. And another thing is the electrical construction. The course is really, really practical. You learn the very basics, then you can plug in and try out. If it doesn't work, then you have to try again. And it's a quite easy course. As for the steering system, we're using the TR portal from the Siemens software, and we have to program the PLC. So basically, this example is a program which will pick up a can first, and then it will pick one of the ball, and then it will pick the lid to close. I program this with the TR portal. And here is another program. It will sort different cans. So as you can see, the first one it took is the metal can. It will sort into that place. And the second can it took is black can. It will sort another place. And then the last one it take is the white can. It will sort into a different tray. And it's quite interesting for me because it's something new. As for the first internship, so basically we have to find it ourselves. The method I use is use email, and then I successfully found one. It's in a very small town, so I have to manage accommodation myself, but I learned a lot from this experience. And I also did another internship. So basically, the second internship I also found it, but it's in the north of Sweden, so it's very far away. I had to find the accommodation ourselves. And the one thing is it's not paid, so you have to do it anyways, and you feel a bit weird if you not pay. And another course is robotics. So basically, you can program the robot in a very, very simple way. And it's quite different from the real world, which it's more complicated. But in this course, you get the basic theory of how the robots works, and it's very helpful for the future. As you can see, the stuff we are doing right here is put, pick, and you have to do the programming to do that by setting the points. And it's quite easy anyways. And then for the third internship, I also did it. It's in a small city near my city, and I also found an accommodation there. It's also not paid. I learned a lot from the MATLAB and drawing using front-like machine. And final thing about the equipment of the school. So the school has a lot of equipment. In the previous rooms, we have the process machine, which we have showed you. And here in this room, it's a robot lab. Here you can see the ABB robot, which we didn't use. And here's the FANUC robot arm, which in my course we didn't use either. But I think there is another program called the robot program, we use it. And here is the robotics, which I showed you earlier in this video. And here is some stuff for the machine safety.